Yo, good people, what it do? It's your boy Raphael Ratliff, aka Mr. Money Train. I just want to take the time out to thank you guys for watching my EPK. Stay tuned.
Wake up in the morning, it's a new day. Feeling fresh as hell, feeling like a new man.
So I grew up in a little small town called Pageant, South Carolina. Population of a little 2,600 people. Once we got a little older, my mom, she decided she wanted better for our life, so she moved to Rock Hill, South Carolina. We moved in, stayed into a shelter for about 2 or 3 months, got on the waiting list to move to Flint Hill Projects, and that's where we reside and grew up.
Got it, because they hate me because of the way I'm living. I know them fans, they watching me because of the way I'm living. She trying to f*** around with a G, she love the way I'm living. And I'ma always keep it jigger, that's the way I'm living.
I've been kind of doing music all my life. Started as a little kid, growing up in the church. You know, my mom, them, musical family on both sides, my mom, my dad. I grew up in the church playing drums at first, started playing keyboard, always was singing. And I really took it serious in 2014. I made a song, Money Train.
Money Train, please come around my way. Can't keep struggling, man, if I do, I might start hustling, man. Money Train, please come around my way. I move house to house, sneak out to count, and I can't keep going.
I came with the name Money Train because of my first single, Money Train. When I made the song, I didn't have a name. Y'all would just be around the city and they'd be like, hey, that's Money Train. What's up, Money Train? And just by making the song and the impact that the song had, it just stuck. So the people gave me the name, I ran with it. Music inspiration. We gotta go to the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, Mr. Golden Glove. You know, he bigger than just an artist. He was like a musical guy. And another great, Jamie Foxx. You know, we kind of got the same path. Grew up in the church, singing, playing piano, writing music also. So, be my top two.
Now lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, yeah. I prayed a lot my
song. Of course you got Biggie and Tupac. I used to listen to Biggie just cause like he was more a lyrical genius, but Pac really related to your soul. And, you know, I was a mama's boy, so I used to love to hear that dear mama all the time.
I'm tired being down at the bottom. The money train ain't came, but I press away. Lord, I know you heard my cry. See this hurt and this pain. Say prayer, change things. Well, ain't a damn thing changed. Hey, when mama come and cry, cause she can't pay the rent. And daddy back on the crack rock, so that's where all the money spent. Baby mama took my son.
Definitely gonna be the look. You know, the hair is already unique. Soon as people see me, they're like, oh, what's up with the hair? It's either they cool, they love it, or they hate it. Take it down. So the look is definitely unique. And my sound is, the range of my sound and my music that I make definitely separates me. You know, I can make a song like Put the Guns Down, that's on a serious tip, and then I can turn around and make a song like The Way I'm Living, make you feel like you have a good time, and then I can touch your soul with a song like Money Train. You know, so just being able to be diverse within the music to touch different people, I feel like that separates me as a whole, you know. I don't really get too blocked in. And of course, when people see me, they think I'm a rapper until I start singing, so.
You make me move, make me move. You got me in a groove. Yeah. Cause she's independent and she grown. She go get it on her own. She don't need a man for nothing but love, yeah. She make me move, shaka like boo, shaka like.
Next 5 years, I see myself definitely topping the charts. Doing more than just hip-hop and R&B, getting into a lot of crossover music, also doing modeling, also getting into movies and start acting, you know, branding myself a whole lot more than just music, showing what I can really bring to the table as a whole.
What would you do when we're out of? I wonder what you do, you do. I wonder what you do when we're out of? No, what would you do? No. What would you...
My way of giving back would be to put like a boys and girls club for the sports. When kids get out of school, they got somewhere to go to get the tutoring for the grades, make sure they do the homework, and then make sure they got a practice facility, whether it's rain, sleet, or snow. You know, it was always provided with the services. And also with going into the community mentoring, we were having like a big brother program, letting kids know just because you don't play sports, you don't have to revert to the streets to sell drugs. You can be anything you want to be. Last but not least, teaching kids about economics and development. You know, even if you don't go to college, you still can go take a trade, you know. And once you take those trades, it gives you the opportunity to go into business for yourself. You know, you don't have to always go work for somebody. But once you put in the work, you learn the trade, you get it up on your belt, now you have the opportunity to be your own boss.
If you can see that we're being mistreated and we're all that we got, so lean on me.
My biggest motivation is my kids. You know, they look up to me and how I came up playing ball. You know, I got two of my kids out here right now, Zayn and Malik. They love to play ball also just because they seen what daddy was doing and you know, just to be able to have the opportunity that I didn't have, I can give it to my kids. You know, my daddy, he wasn't really there to coach me up to do drills and to get on my nerves, you know. So I really take that and try to implement it to my kids, let them know, like, no matter what you're doing, you're gonna have to put in hard work. Even if they weren't playing football, they wanna play basketball, soccer, golf, whatever they're doing, I'm letting them know, like, it's gonna be hard work, no matter what you do in life.
Wake up in the morning, it's a new day. Feeling fresh as hell, feeling like a new man. Thumb and through the hundreds, that's a new pay. Sweat is life, I'm living like a movie.
And I don't feel like being bothered. You know, that's what I run to. I run to the music. It's more of a therapeutic for me. Whatever I'm feeling, I can just get it out. I ain't got to explain it to you. I don't really have a care in the world how you feel. I just put the music out, and it eases the pain, whatever I'm going through.
I just wanna know why the only way to fly is just by dying. So much pain in my heart, I can't stop this cry.
Coming up in the church, gospel definitely influenced my music. You know, having that foundation as a kid, playing drums, keyboard, singing, you know, it's kind of ground rooted.
All I forgot is, listen to me, put your guns down, don't shoot, put your guns down, police, I freeze, now please, put your guns down.
I want to be remembered as the guy that motivates you. Whenever you think about it, you get inspired, because of the simple fact, you know I came from nothing. You know I came from no lights, no water, no toilet, you know. I beat all the odds. Even when the odds was against me, I never gave up. And I always motivated. I'm a kid that really came from nothing. Look around me. If I can do it, you can do it.
Tired of being down at the bottom. Tired of going through this drama. They say more money, more problems. I ain't got shit, but I still got problems. Jay-Z say money in a thing. I swear he lied to me. I'm gonna book my ticket right now.